Hello students, in the last class we have discussed about what are lanthanides and their properties. Today we will discuss about the extraction of lanthanides, how these lanthanides are extracted from a different minerals. There are many minerals which contains lanthanides, for example monazite sand, bastnaesite, cerite, etc. But the most important mineral that contains lanthanides, the monazite sand. This monazite sand, which consists of all the lanthanide phosphates and thorium, zirconium, silica and some other impurities. Let us see how these lanthanides are extracted from the monazite sand. At firstly, this monazite sand is powdered and digested with the concentrated H2SO4 until the pasty mass of lanthanide sulfates and excess of sulfuric acid is formed. By adding concentrated H2SO4, these lanthanide phosphates which are present in the mineral, that converts into a lanthanide sulfate. So that here, after adding a concentrated sulfuric acid, we'll get the residue of lanthanide sulfates as well as the centrifugate, that is solution. So by filtration or centrifugation, we can separate the lanthanide sulfates from the solution. Then this pasty mass is treated with the cold water so that all the lanthanide sulfates gets dissolved in a cold water except the zircon and silica. Here also we can separate that silica and zircon by filtration. So now we consider the filtrate or the centrifugate that consists of a lanthanide sulfate, because we are separating the lanthanides from the monazite sand. So here this solution of lanthanide sulfate that also consists of a thorium, it is an actinide. So in order to separate this actinide thorium from the solution, how to dilute it and then adjust the pH to its alkali medium, then the thorium is separated as a thorium phosphate. Once again you consider the filtrate, the centrifugate, then it is treated with the sodium sulfate. After adding the sodium sulfate to the solution of a lanthanide sulfate, the lighter lanthanides that separated or it precipitated as a double salts. Lighter lanthanides in the sense lanthanum to samarium, that gets separated from the solution, and the heavier lanthanides, that is from gadolinium to lutetium, that remains in the solution. So I am explaining the separation of a cerium from the monazite sand, that cerium that belongs to the lighter lanthanide, so that I am concentrating on the lighter lanthanides, that is the precipitate. Double salts of this lighter lanthanides that is treated with the hot sodium hydroxide solution, and after adding this sodium hydroxide solution to the double salts of a lanthanide sulfate solution, then all the lanthanide sulfates are converted into lanthanide hydroxide, and after that this lanthanide hydroxides are washed until it is free from sodium sulfate. Then it is dried in air at 373 Kelvin. Once you dry the lanthanum hydroxides, all the lanthanum hydroxides gets converted into their oxide forms. After drying, the cerium is completely oxidized and other lanthanides also converted into its lanthanum oxides, and then these lanthanum oxides are treated with the dilute nitric acid, and here all the lanthanide oxides that gets dissolved in a dilute nitric acid except cerium oxide. so that we can separate the cerium oxide or cerium from the solution. And then this cerium oxide that is treated with the 85% of a nitric acid, and it is treated with the dilute sulfuric acid, and this cerium gets precipitated as a red basic nitrate of cerium, so that we can separate the cerium from the monazite sand. And there are different methods to separate the other elements which are present in the cerium, and also we can use the different reagents to separate the other lanthanides which are present in other minerals. Now we discussed about the extraction of lanthanide. Next we will move to the next topic, that is the separation of lanthanides. Here also there are different methods to separate the lanthanides. Like solvent extraction method, ion exchange method, thin layer chromatography or paper chromatography, etc. But I am going to explain the very important method of separation, that is the separation of lanthanide, that is from ion exchange method, and it is one of the chromatographic method. And in any chromatographic method, if you consider, that consists of two phases, like a stationary phase and the mobile phase. Stationary phase in the sense it is a constant, and the mobile phase is moving. So before going to explain the separation or a procedure for the separation, we should know some of the terms here, like cation exchange, cation exchanger and cation exchange capacity. What is cation exchange? And it is one of the chemical reaction in which the cation present in the solid that undergo exchange with the ions of a similar charge that is present in the solution. Here solid in the sense it is a stationary phase, and the solution in the sense it is a solution of a lanthanide ions. Then cation exchanger, it may be an insoluble solid, it may contain the cationic group that capable of undergoing a exchange reaction with the other ions that is present in the solution. So this cation exchanger is also called as a resin. And this cation exchange capacity, that is imparted by adding some of the acidic groups, so such as a carboxylic acid group, sulfonic acid group, etc. So that after adding the acidic group, the H plus ions that is present in the resin or acidic group, that can be exchanged with the ions of the solution. For example, we consider the COOH group, that is the acidic group which is present in the resin. Then H plus ion present in the COOH group that undergo exchange with the ions of the solution. Then COO minus ion which remains as such in the resin. So the exchange reaction between the ions and the ions of the cations of the resin, that can be expressed like this. This M3 plus ion means it is the ion or it is the lanthanide ion, and 3H means it is the ions, cation present in the resin that undergo exchange with each other and it gives a 3H plus ion, it is free from the resin. And next, that is the cation exchange capacity. Here the cation exchange capacity is depends upon the size and charge of the ions. The cation exchange capacity that increases with the increases of charge, and it decreases with the increases of size. If the elements have a similar size, then charge play an important role. For example, here thorium 4 plus, Al 3 plus, Ca 2 plus and Na plus. they have a similar size, so we have to consider the charge. The thorium that exhibit a charge of +4, so that which has a higher capacity to undergo exchange reaction than Al3+, then Ca2+ and Na+. And in case of the similar charge, then size play an important role here. The elements which are having a smaller size, that has a higher tendency to undergo a exchange reaction. For example, H+, CH+, RB+, etc. Here H+, which has a smaller size, so that has a higher tendency to undergo a exchange reaction. And this ion exchange chromatography is also similar to that of a column chromatography. And here the elements which have a higher tendency to undergo exchange reaction, that held at the top of the column, and other elements which are further down, that is according to their exchange capacity. And once the solution of the elements or a lanthanide solution that is poured into the resin or a column, then the ions which are present in the resin undergo exchange with the ions of the solution. Then now the ions, that means the lanthanide ions which held to the column or the resin. In order to separate these ions from the resin, we need one more solution called as a eluent. But in this case, we are considering a strong acid such as a HCl to separate the lanthanides. HCl that consists of a strong H plus ion, so that once we add HCl to the resin, now H plus ions of HCl, hydrochloric acid, once again it undergo exchange with the resin, and the ions of the solution, which is the which ion which is attached to the column, that set free, and that comes out with the eluent, that comes out with the HCl, so that we can separate the lanthanides from the lanthanides by using a ion exchange chromatography. Here we consider the example of trivalent ions of a lanthanides, that is from lanthanum to lutetium. The lanthanum Na3+, it is the trivalent ion, Na3+ to lutetium 3+. Here the size that decreases with the increases of atomic number, but there is a relationship between the degree of hydration and the size of the ions. As the size decreases, degree of hydration increases, so that Lu3+, which have a greater degree of hydration, so that it is less firmly held to the resin, so that if you elute this, the Lu3+ comes out first and other elements next, and La3+ is comes out last. That is because of the degree of hydration. This method is a very important method to separate the lanthanides. And one more method is there, that is a solvent extraction method. It is based on the solubility of the lanthanide compounds. And here the extraction of lanthanides, that extraction of lanthanide elements, that increases with the increases of atomic number. So, but most important technique is the ionization technique. By using the ion exchange method, we can separate the lanthanide ions. Thank you.